Hey family, today we are excited to talk about how to read the Bible, especially when you have no idea what the Bible is, you have no one coaching you, and you're not even sure where to start. So we're going to dig into how to read the Bible and where to start. When it comes to Christianity, obviously, like, Christianity is a faith based on the Bible, this thing we call the Bible, and there's, you know, you can go to school and study it for 20 years and there's so much depth in it. So it leaves people wondering, like, where the heck do I start? How do I, you know, what's God, what's history, what's culture, all this kind of stuff. So what I, even as someone who's been a Christian for a long time, it's valuable for me, but for someone who's just getting into the Bible, what I like to do is tell them to start in the Gospels, which makes the question, like, what are the Gospels? So the Bible really is 66 books. So, like, it's a book, but made up of a bunch of books. And Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John are the books where it talks about Jesus when he walked on this earth. I find that as the most applicable because it can show me, like, how I'm supposed to walk, how I'm supposed to act, what jokes I'm supposed to laugh at. Like, it changes how I go through my daily life. On the super practical, because we live in the era that we live in, like the digital world, you can, we're like watching this on YouTube. People are hanging out with us from all over the world. So they can go to the App Store, Android, whatever they got, and download YouVersion, which is the Bible app. When they download it, they'll be able to open it and in a million different languages and all the different things. And then it looks like this. You can scroll through the different books and just look for Matthew. Click on that, chapter one, and start reading. So download the YouVersion app, start in the book of Matthew, and start reading.
So if you're a new Christian and you're just starting in your, what we would call your walk with the Lord and reading the Bible, the first thing I would say is get a good Bible, whether it's on your phone and you're looking at the Bible app, or I would say get a good Bible translation like the NIV or the Amplified, because that tends to really bring out the meanings in the Bible. So I happen to like the TPT, which is called the Passion Translation. It's a great Bible because it really brings out the expression of the meanings. It is just really New Testament and then Proverbs and Psalms, but where you're wanting to go is to get into what we call the Gospels. And the Gospels are Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And so the second thing I would say to you in that moment is to read one of those Gospels. And then just remember that when you're reading the Bible and when you're looking through it, when you're studying it, you don't want to just pull out specific verses, but you kind of want to read it in context. So don't isolate one verse, but look at the chapter as a whole. Look at all the other verses that surround it. I think the next thing, or the last thing that I would even say when you're new to studying the Bible, would be to remember why we're doing this. It's not to gain knowledge. It's not to fill your head with a bunch of information. It's not just so you can turn around and quote scriptures to people. It's because the highest price was paid for you to have a relationship with Jesus. So when you're reading the scriptures, you're actually entering into his thoughts and his mind. Really, you're discovering the character of God. So with that, you always have to keep in mind that you're really developing a growing relationship between his word and him and you.
Yeah, there's this story in, it's Acts 8, where there's this man in a carriage and he's reading from the prophet Isaiah, and he does not understand what he's reading. And the Holy Spirit speaks to Philip, one of the apostles, and says, I want you to go over and walk along beside the carriage. And so you get this picture of someone who's reading their Bible, but they don't understand what's being said. And the Holy Spirit, who is the one to teach us and to lead us into all truth, speaks to someone and says, walk alongside them. And I think that's a really cool way, especially for a new believer or someone who really hasn't, you know, dug into the Word of God in any kind of like deep way. That's a really good way for them to get started, is to do it alongside another believer. Philip is invited into the carriage and he begins to talk to the man about the scripture, and he points to Jesus. And I think that kind of points to another approach, I guess I could say, to reading the Word of God. Understanding that in the book of John at the beginning, it says that Jesus is the Word made flesh. So the idea is that all of scripture is pointing to Jesus. And so one of the ways to approach reading your Bible is to see Jesus in it. Like, what is he saying? Like, how is he being described? How is he being pointed to? And that's something that I think could be really beneficial for somebody as they're getting into the Word of God. It is a good idea to start with the Gospels and to discover who Jesus is, the things that he said. I love when his words are written in red because it literally, even visually, makes it stand out. Like these are the words of God. To someone who is not sure if God is speaking to them or not, I would say a few things. One, I just want to affirm the fact that you can hear from God. You are made to hear from God. In the same way that God made you with ears on your head, he made you spiritually to hear the sound of his voice. It says in John 10 that the good shepherd will speak and his sheep will recognize his voice. So it is God's will that you recognize his voice, that when he speaks, you are aware of it, you can sense and discern it. It's important that you understand that. But at the same time, I want you to also understand that there is an enemy. And the enemy will constantly question and accuse you and try to cloud what God is saying. In fact, the first thing we really hear from the enemy in scripture is at the very beginning of it all. And what does he question? He questions what God said. He said, did God really say that? So it's natural for us to perhaps hear something or become sensitive to something and be like, is that God speaking? You're always gonna have that nagging voice coming after you, like, is that really from God? And you know, like oftentimes, I feel like you can weigh God's word against what he says in his written scripture. Like when he's speaking something, if your heart is tender and responsive to the Lord, you're gonna pick up on the signals. You're gonna be in tune with the sound of his voice. If you're pursuing him, you're going to be hearing from him. But at the same time, when you're not sure, this is the luxury of having the written word of God, because it will not contradict itself.